Now we'll understand what is I enumerable and what is I queryable in link. So there is a very small subtle difference which can have a huge performance penalty, or we can say performance performance issues, performance consequences. Consider these chart that I've drawn. Here I've written I enumerable x is equal to ls dot where some lambda. I've written the same thing here. I queryable x is equal to ls dot where. I enumerable and I queryable are both interfaces, and both of them are available on this ls dot where and ls dot where. Then in the next statement here I write z is equal to x dot take 10, and here I write x dot take 10, exactly same statement. And here I write where v is equal to z dot order by, v is equal to z dot order by, exactly same statements, but here I write enumerable and here I write queryable. Let us see what is the difference. When you write queryable, this means still more queries can be appended to it before execution. So I write x is, since x is I queryable, this means at this point I can still append this take clause to this one, no execution. And even further, I am writing z dot order by, and z is acting on queryable, and here also I am adding one more condition here, or one more SQL clause here. So this means execution hasn't still occurred here. Even here the execution hasn't occurred. Execution will occur once I take out I enumerable out of this. How do we take I enumerable? We can take I enumerable by writing to dot to list or using a for each loop. That is the point of execution. When you are using a for each loop, you are taking out I enumerable. So I queryable will prevent execution. It will allow you to chain SQL clauses, but execution won't take place. Execution will take place only when the for each loop has been called for, or specifically dot to list has been done, or dot to dictionary, or whatever. Whereas on the left side you have I enumerable. Enumerable means that in the very next step, before operation, this operation, the original one will be executed. So it means take 10 will occur on X held in memory. Database query has already occurred here and the results are in your memory, and this take 10 is executing against the memory. And Z is also executing against the memory. And any for each after that will execute on in memory. The execution occurs here at the very next step of taking out I enumerable. Execution doesn't occur here. Be very careful. They both support deferred execution. Deferred means at a next step, not on the same line. So execution hasn't occurred at this step, but because it is I enumerable, at the very next step execution occurs first and then that step takes place. Whereas in case of queryable, it is deferred and this will not occur. This will wait till chaining can occur. You are chaining, this is where clause no execution, to where you have chained this one take, and then you have chained this order by, and finally only when you use a for each loop, the entire query will be sent to the database and the results brought from